I cannot compete with this. Heck, if she were a lesbian and took a fancy to me, I wouldn't refuse her. So, you know, yes, there's a man, but there's some constants and there's some variables.
Yes, that's great because you actually describe the relationship that Tara has with two of her best friends in the book, and it's amazing because there's Rekha, who's this sexy go-getter, who's like, I remember him well. He used to be a quiet, chubby, studious little boy back then, with a 10-acre property in Nainital called the Holy Saints Academy had been our universe.
I'm gonna go to the end.
Oh no!
I hope everyone's not too bored, yeah? People are looking a little sleepy. Okay. She lives here? I asked incredulously, sitting bolt upright and looking around stupefied. We're on the expansive, tree-lined Aurangzeb Road, which remains cool and shady even through the harshest of summers. Nobody lives on Aurangzeb Road. Nobody but the richest industrialists and the senior-most politicians of the country. I know for a fact that a private house on this street costs 100 crore rupees, perhaps more. It's only for the impossibly rich, the Jindals and the Birlas of the world. I knew she was rich, super rich even, but this address had changed the complexion of the scenario entirely. I cannot compete with this. Heck, if she were a lesbian and took a fancy to me, I wouldn't refuse her. So why blame poor Arun?
Thank you. I love both these passages so much because one, I think everyone is guilty of looking up at old Facebook pictures of friends and seeing the ones who didn't turn out so well and feeling a little less inside, and also the, you know, stalking the cute ones secretly.
Always.
And having lived in Delhi, Aurangzeb Road was exactly that description. It was always like, oh my god, if this person lives here, then they're... Literally, I remember we went to some house party once and the furniture was gold-plated.
Yes. We went to many of those.
One of those.
Okay, well, I'm not going to actually read out something from this because I'm hoping that all of you are going to eventually read this book for yourselves. So thank you, Malini and Richa, for doing that for me. But we are happy to take questions from the audience if there are any, and you know, you can address them to any of us if you like.
So kindly raise your hand and we'll take in the questions, please.
Apartments even in the heart.
Exactly, exactly.
There you go.
So I think, and I also think flirting is healthy. Even if you're married, you should still flirt and do that, but you should know where not to cross the line, you know, so all the guys don't get too happy. They're like, ah, she said, go flirt.
Yeah, yeah, I know. My husband's sitting in the front row. I'm like, okay, don't grin too much.
Dina,
more advice for
you.
The women. Yeah. Huh, by
Excuse
the
me, one question for you. The cute you build on the title.
Yeah, okay, that's nice. That's a nice question. It's basically because it's this moment of realization for this girl who's never had much confidence in herself, and you know, she's a bit of a wallflower and she doesn't aspire to too much because she doesn't think she's capable of it. And it's this sort of watershed moment for her which is triggered off by something where she actually says literally that. She says, really? Who? Me? So that's where it comes from. Also really resonated with me because even if you change yourself, you know, how far is that going to take you? It's probably going to take you a few months. At the end of the day, you can't change who you really are on the inside. And eventually, it's not going to work if someone is in love with you for somebody you're not. So the advice is clear. Don't do it, but everyone still does, and women will keep doing it. Men will keep doing it too, I suppose. Yeah.
That's what I was getting at. Don't beat the men up, yeah? Everyone changes to be in a relationship just to make the other person comfortable. It's like if I'm vegetarian and they're non-vegetarian, they'll start being a little more considerate about the smaller things like food and comfort. So it starts there, and everybody changes. Your mom will change to have you. Your dad will change to have your mom. Everyone changes when they're together. It's how society works. But we should not do it at the cost of our truth. But love? I'm an artist and I got my heart broken at maybe 16, and I've been breaking hearts since then. But I feel like if you have your heart broken, then true magic happens, you know. You write better, you sing better, you dance better, you look better. You do everything a little bit better because you've gone through that, and it's nice to go through that early. Then if I mean, I'm hoping it doesn't happen again, but it's nice to go through that
once
earlier.
Once is enough. Yeah,
once is enough. There's a line in Rockstar, actually. And I was telling somebody ये तो मैंने 16 साल में बोला था. जब दिल टूटता है तो गाना अच्छा निकलता है something like
that. That's awesome. And one more question for you guys, for both of you. If you could go back and give your 18-year-old self some relationship advice, what would it be?
For me, it's really simple. He's not worth it. I did so many wrong turns and you know went down the wrong alley so many times. I just go back and say he's not worth it. That's it.
My 18-year-old, actually I'll just let her be. I'll be like, okay, go experience it and see what happens. And then you'll come till here, sitting on the stage and talking about it.
Same. I want to just go back and tell my 18-year-old self, like, you go through the heartbreak, do everything, but don't worry, it works out great. You end up with a really cute guy, so it's fine.
You do, Tony. Mal, one question for you. You know, I have a lot of friends who say that they can never get over their high school crush or, you know, that first love. Do you think that's true? You know, I don't think that, and this is probably
a please advice. Ask, let's
I think
ask
you should answer one question.
You know, I actually checked with him before the event and I'm like, would you be willing to participate?